presentation. It's entitled, Good Governance, A Bridge Too Far. Now that we have forthcoming election, good governance is probably one of the most abused terms now in this country by traditional and corrupt politicians. It is a very common word. Common word. But unfortunately, it's still far from our own very grasp. Napakalayo pa ho ng ating lalakbay. And that's the reason why I mentioned it as a bridge too far. But first, let me show you and share with you the words of Albert Einstein. He said, the world has become a dangerous place. Not because of evil people, but because good men do nothing about it. I see a lot of good people here today. Good people here today who are willing to risk everything, especially their own personal security, because they believe that it is about time that we have to act now. Another word from Zig Ziglar, when he said, your life is your soul of the choices that you make. Sabi nga nila, the choices that we make or make us. The choices that we make will define our character. Will also define our future. But if you don't like your life today, then better to make better choices now. So that is actually the background of what? Behind my presentation today. This is called from the DOF data. In 2016, when President Duterte took over, our national debt was at 5.9 trillion pesos, accumulated for almost five decades. 5.9 trillion. After his term, aggravated by the pandemic, 11.7 trillion. In just 6 years, na doble na ho, and more than 100%. Last year, our national debt was already at 14.6 trillion pesos. This year, the projection is at 15.8 trillion pesos. But that is based on a 54:1 exchange rate. Currently, our exchange rate naglalaro na siya sa 58, 56. And about 3 days ago, I saw a data released by the Bureau of Treasury, the Department of Budget and Management. And this is the latest projection for this year. It's like this. It's not going to be 15.8, but 16.06 trillion. Next year, it will be at 17.35 trillion. And this is actually one of my first questions when I saw former Secretary Jess Stanislao of the Department of Finance. Sir, are we capable of paying our debt? Nagsabi naman niya sa akin, oo naman Benji, kaya naman natin yan. Because there's such thing as a macroeconomic allocation wherein financial institutions actually look at the health of our economy. But, our ability to pay our debt will depend on our ability to manage our leakages. What are those leakages? The big chunk of those leakages actually goes to corruption, which we estimate around 18-20% of our national budget. But how do they do it? Paano nila ginagawa? Kala natin millions, hundreds of millions ang nawawala. Sometimes when you talk about corruption, You think it's just a concept. Pag sinabi mong it's just a concept, it doesn't at all bother us. But if we see figures, based on my own experience showing it, especially to different groups, young people, even to people in my own kind, local government officials, sa kanila nare-realize na kailangan na palang nating gumalaw. Yung ibang mga kabataan, alam niyo sabi sa akin, sana sakalit na lang natin sila.
Punin mo doon yung cellphone.
2023 video. This is actually data taken from the GAAP. 2023, and thank you very much to Mayor JR because he exposed me sa budgeting. He's the president of the Center for, or CEO, Center for National Budget. Siya po talaga nagpaintindi sa akin tulad ng ginawa niya sa kay Senator Lacson at kay Congressman Romney Hapo. Ipinasa po siya sa akin. Finally, I understood. I started to understand our national budget. Last year, we paid 582 billion pesos alone for interest to pay our national debt. Hindi po nababawasan yung ating principal. The year after, look at the big difference, huge difference. 582 went up to 670, that's 90 billion pesos. 670 billion pesos. And for us to be able to reduce our national debt, ang dapat babayaran natin this year should be around, next time, 1.241 trillion. So where is, saan natin kukunin ang 1.241 trillion? If you look at the GAAP, tatlo po yung major parts ng GAAP. The regular budget or regular appropriation, the special purpose fund, which is usually yung regular appropriation, yung po yung sinasabi ng mga department heads. Yung special purpose fund is actually, many of these are unprogrammed funds, but to be released upon the approval of the president. And then, of course, the automatic appropriations. Kaya nakita nyo, nandiyan ho yung NT, national debt, pati ho yung ating BARB, which is receiving about 70 billion pesos. If you look at all these figures here, wala po kayong makikita ang 1.241 trillion. Kasi wala po tayo niyan. Ibig sabihin, ito, utang na ito, uutangin po uli natin, pampayad lang uli ito. Dadagdagan pa natin, and it's very unfortunate, na yung dinadagdag pa natin sa uutangin natin, majority of that goes to someone's pocket. And it's not in millions. It's not in hundreds of millions, but in billions of pesos. And don't be surprised when I say yung billion of pesos napupunta lang sometimes or in several instances sa isang politiko lang. Every year, some political. And I had the chance to talk to several, colleagues of these types of politicians. At sinasabi, alam mo, Mayor, Mayor Benji, sasabihin ko sa iyo, dati natin 10% lang. And no less than Secretary Babe Simpson admitted to me, Mayor Benji, pinay ko lang talaga sila sa 10%. And former congressmen who are now governors, sinasabi rin sa Mayor Benji, when we were 10% lang naman talaga. May umakyat na sa 25%. Pero lately, 30% na, 40% na. Can you just imagine? 40%. It's like this. How are they doing it? Classic case. You see this all over the Cordillera. This one of those pictures along Cannon Road. The famous or infamous rock netting project, or we usually call it the rock fall protection projects, both active and passive. Ito po yung meron pong stud, ito po yung active na type. Then I'll show you another one. Ito po yung papunta naman sa Gleba, Vizcaya. Next. Ito naman yung isang klase na rock net, rock screening naman to. This is passive type. Ito po yung walang status. So I ask data from the implementing agency, the PWS. Can you give me a copy of the contract as chairman of the regional committee on regional RDC committee on good governance and administration? Binigyan ko ako ng link. Balik ko muna, please. Binigyan ko ako ng link. For 1 week po, binuksan ho namin yung link. Wala po kami makita contract or anything whatsoever that would relate to this. Until finally, I got tired and I asked the RDC chairman, Mr. Chair, can we compel and request our RDC secretary to conduct a study on drug netting projects in the entire Cordillera region. Tapos nila yung kanilang report ng August. I got a copy first week of October. It's a 17-page report. This is approximately 1 square meter. Let me show you how much it cost that is costing. In page 9 of that document, it's like this. This is page 9. You could see 25,000 pesos per square meter. In 2018, it was at 17,000 pesos. In 2020, I remember when we had that public hearing, city council hearing, sa city council ng Baguio, some of our councilors asked the PWS engineer, how much is the rock netting project? Sabi nila, 14,000 pesos per square meter. That was in 2020. And then, I raised my hand, and the vice mayor said, well, let's acknowledge the mayor. And I asked, engineer, mukha yata hindi yata 14,000. I believe it is 18,000. Hindi, sir, 14,000 yan. And then I told him, Mr. Chair, I have a copy of the contract. And the contract says it's 18,000 per square meter. Or 17,000 per square meter, rather. And then finally, sabi nun, nagtinginan yung mga engineers, oo nga pala, sir, 7,000, 17,000. But now it's at 25,000 pesos. Now let me go back to sa picture na yun. Let me go back to sa picture para at least sumavisualize ka. I came from Steel Asia, the biggest steel company in the Philippines. So I was very fortunate to be the senior vice president for operation, and I had this estimated. Sabi yung sa akin, sir, kung yan yung yan, estimate namin, bigyan po, itemize na estimate, including the stud. Ito, walang stud. It's around 6,000 pesos. 6,000 pesos. And then, last month, a member of the Philippine Institute of Civil Engineers approached me. Sabi niya, Mayor, I was in Zamboanga when you did the presentation on good governance, and you showed us pictures of the rock netting projects in the Cordillera. Yes? Meron po sana akong i-correct po doon sa figure nyo, lalo na doon sa cost. Ano ba? Nakamali pala ako. Oh, Mayor, hindi po 6,000. So, ano yung figure dapat pala? 4,300 po. Paano mo alam? Kami po yung mga nagsusupply doon sa mga private na mga projects. Next slide, please. This is the last page of the 17-page report. Please take note, just to give you a background. The entire rock netting project, hindi Cordillera pa lang ito, iba pa ho yung sa ibang lugar. I've been going around, sinasabi nila sa akin, ah, meron din sa people, meron din sa Yungto, meron din sa Mindanao, meron din sa Mindanao. Meron din po sa Visayas. Sa Mindanao. kordilyera pa lang ito. I thought all along it's 5 billion pesos. And I was really surprised. Please, yung figure po rito, dagdagay mo natin ng 3-0. I was really surprised that the total cost 2017 to 2023 was 14.6 billion pesos. Please take note that the group of politicians, corrupt politicians, took over in 2020. When I say took over, they took over, as simply took over. So in 2017, ito nyo rito, Abra, Baguio, Benguet, Lantuya. The total number of projects po niya is 448 rock netting projects. Alam mo yan, 400-something. Natuno sa report. The total cost in 2017 started with 1 billion, went up to 1.5 in 2019. When they took over, in 2020, it went up to 4.8 billion. Following year, it was at 11.3 billion. It went up to 16.6 trillion. Dito ho sana sa mataas pa ho yata ito, dapat ito mga 12 billion yata ito sa 2023. Kaya lang, if you remember when I started talking about the corruption, in July 2023, nahinto yung mga rock-netting projects, temporarily. Kaya 8.7 na lang ho. If you add these 4 years, that's about 41.5 billion pesos. Ngayon, eto po yun. Kumapit po sa akin mga contractor. Mayor, pagod na ho kami. Bakit pagod na kayo? Pagod na ho kami sa kadideliver ho ng pera sa kanila. Cash sa kanila. How much are you? Magkano bang kinukuha sa inyo? Ngayon, 40%. How do you deliver it? In luggage, cash. Sabi ko sa kanila, ilan pa kayong contractor? Ngayon, hindi naman po kami mga contractor. Ano kayo? Subcontractor kami. So, sino yung contractor? Sila po. Sino pala nagsusupply sa inyo? They mentioned to me the company name. Sino'y may-ari nung itong kumpanya na to? Sila rin po. So assuming they're getting 40% and they're the contractor, conservatively, the profit of 10% and another 10% a supplier, conservatively, 60% taken from 41 billion pesos. That's around 24 billion pesos pocketed going to the pockets of politicians and government officials. Magkano ang kinikita ng isang media personality na lang na nandito? Swerte na ako siguro kung may kinita ako sila 1,000 o 1,005. Yung tricycle driver, 400, 500. Yung mentor, 500, 400. Yung jeepney driver, 600, 700. Many of these people are earning half a million pesos every day without paying any tax, and no accountability whatsoever. Is that the kind of society that we're going to pass on to the next generation? Yan po ba ipapamana natin? If we are good men and we do nothing about it. Next slide, please. Do I still have time? Okay lang po ba? Just to take me another 10 minutes po, okay lang po. And because of the corruption, look at what happened. Nag-erode na ho. Another slide. That's what happened. Still, wala pa rin nung nag-conduct na investigation. wala rin pong congressional investigation man lang. Nakakalungkot na billions and billions of pesos. Instead, na sana ito ang tutupukan nila, iba naman yung interest nila na pinag-uusapan sa mga kanilang mga investigation. Next slide. Another is, you're probably familiar with this, the infamous rock cat's eye project. Safety devices, road safety devices. Kasi ang paborito ho nilang mga projects, first, flood control, road opening, asphalt overlay, at ito pong mga road safety devices. Paano ko malalaman? Eh, yun yung sinasabi sa akin ng mga contractor mismo. So this is the cat's eye. And every piece of that, meron pong tinatawag na detailed unit price analysis. Just to justify the cost of each unit. Lalagyan mo nila next. Ayoko akong bigyan nito, kaya nagawa ko na lang po is nagkanap po ako ng source ko at ito po yung pinadala sa akin. Detailed unit price analysis, lupa. Mga engineers, pamilya ko kayo dyan, mga contractors na dito. So dyan no nilalag, ipapatungo nilalag, ang skid labor, kung ano nilalagay dyan, just to justify. Next slide, please. Please take note, 143 by 47 millimeter ho yung one. Yan o. And the cost is 11,720 per unit. What I did was to get in touch with a legitimate supplier. The first thing that I asked him is, padala mo muna ako, pwede padala niyo muna ako ng certification na kayo po yung legitimate at pumasa po yung standard. Pinadala po sa akin. Yung pinirmahan po mismo ni Secretary ng DPWAS. And then, I asked for a quotation. Bibili kami ng mga 100 pieces, sabi ko. And he sent me this quotation. 143 by 47, 1,350 pesos. Sabi ko, bakit naman napakamahal ng butas? Eh, inespect ko naman yung butas eh. Sabi niya, 200 lang actually yan eh. Pero ginawa ko ng 500 para naman doon sa mga kontraktor at trabahan ko. Another 246 for the bata sa about 1,900. So 11,720 minus 1,900. That's about 9,800 pesos. I just don't know ilan pong millions ang binili kasi it's all over the country. It's all over the country. Millions for every million na binili, that's 9.8 billion pesos. Bakit po? 2 billion, that's almost 20 billion pesos. 2 million pesos. But its number of pieces was in millions of pieces. Ano? Just to justify din ho, na marami dapat ang o-orderin, ang standard po yan, ni-research ko po yan, ang standard to between 2 cuts eye is 10 meters. Sinukat ko yung nilagay ko nila sa session roads, iba sa Marcos Highway, it's 5 meters. At pwede naman ho, dahil ho, hindi naman kailangan para mas maraming makuberan ito. Pwede naman sa gitna lang, okay naman po. Ang ginawa ho nila, nilagyan ho nila yung gitna, nilagyan pa ho yung gilid, dalawa. Kaya ang ganda-ganda ho ng mga kalsada ho namin papunta sa Baguio. Thus, finally, I realized it's not detailed unit price analysis. It's actually detailed unit profit analysis. Next part, please. Hindi pa ho yan ginawa nila. Because they control the budget, kinuha nila yung AICS. Kami sa local government, every time we have a workshop, nalulungkot kami na halos magmalimos kami para makakuha kami ng AICS. Pero they control their AICS, which is not part of their function. Kinuha pa nila yung, this is financial assistance for those experiencing crisis situation. Kinuha nila yung MAID. May medical assistance for indigent patients. Kinuha pa ho nila yung tupad. Ito naman yung work for cash. Pati ho ba naman scholarship ng TESDA at CHED yung mga parito? Hindi pa ho sila nagsawa. Kinuha pa ho nila pati akad. At pinapamigay din nila, ina-attack pa nilang bigay sa mga media, pumirma kayo, fill out the form. Mabuti na lang sabi ng DSW, they don't qualify. Because ito na lang, isang explanatory ayuda para sa mga kapos. As I mentioned a while ago, this is the politician. He gets 25 to 40%. Hindi pa nagsawa. Siya pa yung contractor, siya pa yung supplier. Triple whammy na ho lahat. Kaya ako sinabi nga ho nila, alam niyo ba nawala na ho? Nawala na ho ang ho eh. Nawala na ho yung SOP. Sabi ko, good news pala yan, nawala na SOP. Oh, kasi sila na eh. Sa kanila na ho lahat yun. So, nawala na ho yung SOP. I challenge you, make an inventory. Make an inventory. Ilan na ho ang contractors? Ilan na ho ang contractors? Yung visible na contractor, iba pa ho yung mga kamag-anak ang contractor, ay contractor, yung misis ang contractor, yung anak ang contractor. At the end of the day, sila pa rin ang contractor. Sila pa rin ang supplier. Nakakalungkot. Ako isa sa mga ibang mga local government units, yung price of medicine, kailangan magpatong yung mga suppliers na 22%, 18%, 22% para makuha lang yung team. Next slide, please. I'll clip lang. Isa-isa lang i-clip. Let me show you based on a revelation of a contractor. How do at for every project, magkano talaga ang naiiwan? I'll show you in percentage. Next slide. Next, click this. What click? Distribution of a project fund. Next. The politician gets 25 to 40%. So let's put it at 30% average. Then, VAT is 7%. Insurance and VAT is 1%. So 38% na ho. Next, sabali na. The implementing agency, go na. Gets 10 to 15%. Depende sa region. So let's say average is 12% for easy computation. That's already 30, that's already 50%. Pero meron pa ho sa back. 2 to 3%. So 52% na ho. Meron pa ho sa contingency. Yung mga mag-inspect na engineers, bago i-release yung checker, meron na naman ibibigay ulit. May mga namamatayan, kumwari, may mga nagkakasakit ulit, hindi dito, magkain lahat. Another 3%, that's already 55%. So 55% na po ang nakuha doon sa budget. Total 55%. Now, magkano na lang ang natira? 45%. Kasama na ho yung profit po ng contractor. Assuming na yung contractor, may sense of nationalism, 10% na lang kukunin niya. Pero yung 10% na yan, makukuha lang niya yung profit niya yan after 1 year. Kasi may retention mo tayo. Retention. So after 1 year. Kung 1 year pa ho niya makukuha, naiwan na lang 35%. Sa tingin niyo, hindi pa siya kukuha uli rito sa 35 kasi after 1 year pa siya. Kukuha pa ho, pauli siya ng 5% dyan. So 30% na lang. Meaning, analogy is, many of you are paying your taxes here. Can you just imagine that most probably around 30% of the tax, total taxes that you pay goes to the project and 70% goes to someone else's pocket. Is it right? is it right? Despite that, only few are raising hell. Why is this happening in the Philippines? We are, majority of us are Catholic, Christian, but why is it that is happening in the Philippines? Why is it that Vietnam is progressing? Sabi nga nila, we're ahead in terms of economy comparing to Vietnam. And I said, I went over and did my own research. Probably in 2017, ang GDP per capita nila, we're still ahead by $40 or $90 rather. And then in 2019 or 2018 rather, they overtook us. GDP per capita was already at $40 more. And then 2022, they were already way ahead at $400 GDP per capita. Yeah. This year, projected estimate GDP per capita, comparing it to our GDP capita, probably would reach around $600. We brag that our export in 2022 was at 110 billion pesos. Our brother, dollars. Vietnam, 399 billion US dollars. When we utilize the local government, kasi nag-workshop po kami, and we compare ourselves, and I came up with this flowchart. When we do our, when we utilize our funding, dadal po siya sa very tedious na process. Call for budgeting, we propose our projects, after that po, may project prioritization, we have to get our barangays involved and our districts involved. After that, nagkakaroon po ng series of stakeholders engagement. Presentation, we have to present it to stakeholders and sectoral representatives. And then finally, we have to have it secure the approval of the City Development Council. Again, another sectoral, this is another sectoral body. And then after that, approval of the budget. Ganyan po, katidyos. Yes, sir. At kailangan nung ilagay sa annual investment plan, kapa-approval, at sa annual procurement plan. Pag nagkaroon mo kayo ng project, nakalimutan nyo ilagay sa AIP. At binayaran nyo, kakabulin mo kayo ng COA at kakasuhan mo kayo. Graft and corruption. Ganyan mo, kahigpit katidyos ang hinaharap po namin as local government. Now, for these corrupt politicians, ay na ako mag-isip kung sino sila. Ito lang po yung kanilang framework. I want this, I want that. Implement daw kagad. I want to put up. Pera ni ganito yan, pera ni ganito yan, pera ho ni ganito yan. Kanitong project na yung pera ho ni kanina, pera ho ni ganito yan. AX, gustong-gusto nilang despite the fact na sinasabi na ng DSWD, bawal na yung kayo nagbibigay, pati yung tole, bawal na kayo nagbibigay. Sila pa rin gusto. Bigay. Para ang tao, iniisip, thank you po, hindi ko nababanggitin kung ano yung pangalan ko nila. Is it fair? Pati ho yung pag-clear ho sa kanilang mga expenses, MOE, certification na lang. Habang kami eh, tanda kami sa resibo, sa tabot-tabot na project proposal. Pareho lang naman ang pera ng bayan ang binagaspos namin. Bakit? Napakaipit sa local government habang sila. And lose dahil ba they control the budget? Is there transparency? Is there accountability with this kind of framework? We are at the crossroad. Silence should no longer be an option. Complacency is actually, I look at complacency as a betrayal of our sense of nationalism. It's about time that good men and women have to speak up. Speak out and act. Silence is not neutrality. It is complicity and tolerance. And silence is probably one of the most powerful weapons of these corrupt politicians. Why? Because it only emboldens them, because nobody likes to talk. Gusto nila yan. It emboldens them. And they will continue doing their trade. Is that the kind of society that we want to live in? Tanong ko na, why the need to act now? Why now? Nabanggit ko sa inyo, it's a legacy that you can pass on to the next generation. Marami nang tumawag po sa akin, marami na rin ang text sa akin, Mayor Benji. Wala lang kami, concern lang kami sa inyo, better to abandon it. Otherwise, kawawa ka lang. You will be subjected to a lot of character demolition. And it's happening. It's happening to us. Pati sa ibang mayors for good governance, we're facing. Ako, meron pa akong 5 kaso, na dipadismiss ko na yung isa. Meron pa akong 4. Anytime, I might be subjected to prevent the suspension. What is happening now? Not that I'm talking now. I know for a fact that they are eyes here. But am I going to abandon the crusade? No. We're not. Why? Because if we're going to abandon it, we're not going to stop fighting, then it is as if we have abandoned and given up on the future of our children, the future of our grandchildren, and most importantly, on the survival of our nation. Mabuti sana ho kung merong Philippine Part 1 o Philippine 1, Philippine 2, Philippine 3. Isa lang po ang Pilipinas po natin. A country worth dying for. I remember when we launched an attempted coup d'etat in 2006, I was asked to stand down and I said, sir, I'm willing to die for this country.
Yes.
Several upperclassmen were sent to me and I said, I'm willing to die for this country. It's just very unfortunate na nasurong kami, wala ko. So instead of 1,000 people going to jail for the special action for spooning my boss, General Sir Bong Franco, I went to Bong Franco and I said, kasalanan ko lahat. So tatlo na lang ko kaming nakulong instead of 1,000. Take ownership. What is our vision? Is our vision. Our vision is to have a nation led by leaders. Leaders who do not manipulate, but inspire. Leaders who do not lead by coercion, but by compassion to their character. Leaders who do not amass wealth or hoard wealth, but uplift and empower communities, especially our young. And most especially, a nation led by leaders who do not lead by greed, but those who serve with them. That's precisely the underlying principles of good governance. Good governance is not only about fighting corruption. It's about empowerment, inclusivity, rule of law, respect for human rights. It's not politics of hate, but the politics of encouragement, of mutual understanding. It's not the politics of criticism, but the politics of encouragement, but the politics of lies, but the politics of truth. That's the kind of society and nation that we envision. But how do we do it? In the city of Baguio, how do I do it? I have to live by example, you know? Everything starts with me as a leader. And I have to be consistent, first term, second term, third term, consistently adhering to the principles of good government. And that's the only legacy that I can pass on to the next generation. Please, take note of these words, and I would like to share it with you. Words of Peter Obi, a Nigerian philanthropist, when he said, when those in government are richer than, or those, when politics is more profitable than industries, when those in government are richer than businessmen and entrepreneurs, then that country will never progress because it manufactures poverty. Words, Ayman, when he said, when you see corruption being rewarded, and honesty is a self-sacrifice, then you know that that country, the society is good. Look around us. Look around us. The corruption, the billions of pesos that are being lost. Kaya nga sabi ng isang man, mayor, they're no longer, my colleagues are no longer using a very young politician, a group of very young politician, mayor. Some of our colleagues are no longer using cash flow. First, hindi ko nakuha agad. Then finally said, kasi hindi nila may bangko sa laki ng pera, kasi billions na. So what they are using are room balls, buying expensive condo units, 4-bedroom, 3-bedroom, converting one, redesigning it for it to be able to hold cash. 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 We're not going to act now. So, we are presenting. There's no substitute to good governance. Think, meron pa bang substitute to good governance? So we are now translating it or transforming into a call to action. Good governance. Get yourself involved. Get yourself involved. Where do we start? Kanino mag-i-start? With each and every one of us. Maraming salamat po sa inyo.